Hello, I'm Rona Rutchik, your host at Art Talk today. You'll be very happy that you turned into this program, for you'll get a chance to meet and see the art of Alexander Trachishin, a resident artist at the Griffis Art Center. Every year, the Griffis Art Center in New London, Connecticut, from a long list of applicants from the United States of America and all the countries internationally, a list of artists who apply for residency are chosen. Three artists are chosen from this long list to visit the Griffis Art Center and live in residence and work in studios on site with art that they have developed. This is a juried competition, and after many hours of looking at slides and reading personal statements, a jury chooses three prizes of artist in residence, and Alexander won one of those prizes, and he is here to talk with us in the studio today. Hello, Alex.
Hi, Rona.
Alexander's nickname is Sasha, and I will call him Sasha, and from his name you can tell that he has come from what we call Russia.
Yeah, actually I came from former Soviet Union, and whole this area called sometimes Russia, but now it's a different country, it's Ukraine. And I was born at the small city, Zhytomyr city, near the Kiev. It's the capital of Ukraine. And I used to study at the Minsk city. It's the capital of the Belarus. It's another country, Belarus now. Mm-hmm. And also I used to travel around the whole country. And I'm feeling that I had a great childhood at the Soviet Union, and I love this country, and I love the people that live down there.
And I'll bet that you feel worried for them somewhat now.
Yeah, right. It's not the best time now for my country, but I still think and I still hope that it will be the great life because down there, because it's really beautiful country, really beautiful people, and I wish them all the best, and I hope when I will be ready and I'll try to help people in my country, and if I will can to do it, I would be able to do it.
Yeah. Well, you're a very lucky young man. A year ago when I met you, you had just come to this country and you could hardly speak any English, although you understood what we were all talking about.
Right.
Now you're
That's
doing
true.
Much better. A lot of people here have been good to you.
Yeah, sure. I am really happy because since I came in this country, it's absolutely new country for me, and I have met great people, very friendly people. At first, it's a Jewish Federation who took care about me, and all personnel of Mitchell College when I used to learn language, and almost all people I have met here. And some people who gave me a chance to work as a teacher, and that's my original profession, art teacher. That's what I did being in Ukraine. I used to teach the kids. And it's hard to say about everybody who gave me a lot. Like, just a feeling, it's very important too, that you are not stranger in this
right.
country. It's very cozy feeling being here.
It's and cozy. Cozy. Well, that's a cute word.
Yeah.
You've picked up one of the American words, cozy. Well, the Griffis Art Center is one of the groups that have been very nice to you, too. And
right.
you're very lucky to have won this Artist in Residence prize.
I really am, yeah, I could say.
The Artists in Residence are offered to share in all the cultural activities in the greater New London area. And then the artists give back to the area in exhibitions and in special projects that we plan that you're a part of.
Yeah.
And we're going to visit in the studio soon to see some of the early work. You say you worked as a teacher?
Right. At the Children's Art School, I used to work with one group of kids during 4 years to get them ready to go to the art college. So it was a long-term project, and some of my early work, it's like works like watercolor landscapes. We did together with the kids when we went outdoor during the summer practice. We went to paint like some pieces of the old town or...
Well, let's see them now, and you can then tell us after we take a look. where they were sighted.
Yeah.
Well, you can see, all of you, from looking at those early Russian pictures, that the committee that chose Sasha knew what they were doing. This is a talented young man. Sasha, where did you learn to paint?
At first, I went to the children's studio, being 6 years old, and I started to do an art to paint. And then probably at the sixth grade at the school, I went to the children's art school. I spent 3 years down there, and then I passed exams at the Minsk Art School, and I used to learn how to paint during 4 years. And then when I have got my diploma, I went back to my native children's art school, and I started to teach kids, and that was all way. How did I do? How I started to work? How I started to paint? And
was the painting that we saw earlier of the town with the church in the center? Was that your town?
Yeah, it's my native town. It's very interesting city, small city, but it's very eclectic. It has all kinds of architecture, and especially the old parts of this city. That's just terrific. And my favorite, it was my favorite place to go with the kids during the summer session, summer practice, to go outdoor to teach them how to paint landscapes and nature and old architecture. And every year at the summertime, we went at the old retainer to paint some parts of.
The paintings that we just saw show some traditional Russian flourishes, some beautiful colorations, and already some stage design.
Right.
That is influenced from various things that you learned or was part of your work?
I should say that at the same time I used to teach kids, I have got a chance to be an art director at the regional puppet theater.
At the puppet theater?
Right.
Ah.
And I did two plays. The first one was, it's a Hungary writer, and the name of the first one was All Mice Like Cheese, and you could see the set design for this play.
The one that we saw earlier was a painting of one of the set designs?
Right.
And it was the one that was in all the different parts.
Yeah, right. And also I did another play, Cinderella. You should know this name.
Mm-hmm, and Americans sure did.
Yeah, right. And also I'm still interested in a group of Russian artists that used to work at the beginning of the century together with a ballet group. And the name of this group was World of the Art Movement.
And World of the Art Movement?
Yeah, right.
And is this along the same time as the Ballet Russe, the Diaghilev group?
Right, right. And they used to work together. And it's very interesting for me because they tried to put some different kinds of art together. And it was incredible. I think it's richest period in the Russian art. And it's like, it's really amazing. Yeah. And
So when we look at your work and we start to think the Leon Bakst influence starts coming into our head, that's a true influence.
Yeah, it's absolutely, absolutely. And I think it's a best Russian artist I have learned from, not alive, just from the pictures.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I really appreciate Russian culture that it has so rich stuff, so rich artists, and you should go sometimes to Russia to see how beautiful this country is. And
I hope to. Yeah. But right now we'll go back to the studio here in New London and look again at some other work, a transition style, actually, that you still did in Russia, but we'll be able to see picks up as you come to work at the Griffis Art Center.
Barcelona, Barcelona, ooh, yours, me and you. I want all the world to see. Lyrical sensation, my guiding inspiration. Now my dream is slowly coming true. Wind is a gentle
demonstration there, Sasha. Tell me about the music we were just listening to. What is this Barcelona? That's not in Russia.
It's interesting. At first, I wanted to pick up the song about my native city, but it's just a little town, Zhytomyr City, and I knew exactly there is no song about it. And I tried to pick up the song about the Kiev city or Moscow, but you know, it's happened often when you're looking for something hard, you could not find it.
Oh, you really cared about the name of the
yeah,
song.
Right. And so more close city I could found the song about was Barcelona. And two of my favorite singers, Freddie Mercury, its former leader of the Queen group, and Montserrat Caballé, of course, greatest opera singer from the Spain. Friendly.
So you have good taste in music. You care about music.
Oh, yeah, sure. Actually, I'm getting my inspiration from the music.
Yes.
And I should have music that I love when I'm painting. And
do you always paint to music?
Yeah.
Weird music?
I never paint in the silent because I could say this way, because I could find something really rich, harmony, movement, dynamic at the music, and it really helps me and inspires.
What about the color?
Yeah.
Does the color of the music have anything to do with the color of your palette?
I should say that probably dynamic of my paintings, it has an influence from the music exactly. Mm-hmm. And I try to pick up the music that I really love, and it's supposed to have a relationship with an idea of my painting, and also it's supporting me to do a painting. So that's the reason I'm painting with the music.
I see.
Yeah.
The painting that we just saw you working on is in the studio with us today. It's now completed.
Sure. Yeah, it's finished. It's done, and it's a recent one. And I should say it's a little bit new way for me because I'm still interested to find something new. I'm sure every alive good artist try to find something new.
Sure.
Nobody will stay the same way whole life. It's just boring. To bring a new impression from the life, to answer a new question artist has.
The art that we just finished seeing, that was a transition of the work from the early work to the work that you're doing at the Griffis Art Center, was very much more covered in motifs that were repeated and repeated and repeated all over. The fables that you use, is that something you're still working on?
Yeah, of course, it's exactly. I'll try to find not universal language, but every particular idea I have gotten from to paint, it needs a new language, not new at all, just probably at some elements, some patterns, because it's really important for my paintings, you could see it. So I'll try to find new way, more interesting, more close to an idea of this particular painting.
I see. What is the name of the painting that you showed us in demonstration that is now in the studio?
The name of this painting is The Song from the Forest, and it tells about something that calls you all the time. And you could feel it, you could hear it, you could go toward it, but
An imagination, this idea of using fables to personify imagination is something that's going to stick with you.
Yeah, right. I have imagination, and also I have so many questions that I try to answer by painting, and
Well, we'll talk about some of those questions in a moment when we come back, but for this moment now, we're going to break for a short commercial about some art objects in and around our greater New London area.
Is a process that fills our lives. See it, enjoy it. This public service announcement is brought to you by the Griffis Art Center, New London, Connecticut.
Hello, we're back in the studio now with Sasha, who is a resident artist at the Griffis Art Center. You were just saying, Sasha, there are so many questions and mysteries to life. Is that what you paint about?
Yeah, right. I think the main question for me and for a lot of artists, because I'm sure even if artists painting realistic things, paintings, or even he paints abstract painting, all of them still painting the miracle of the life, with some different forms.
Miracle of life.
Right. And
is a miracle and a mystery the same thing?
Not exactly. The miracle is just a thing you appreciate from the life, but mystery is the rest of this. And the mystery of the life gives so many questions, and probably you are not able to answer those questions, but just to touch those questions. And that's an idea of my paintings. Mm-hmm. And it's so thin, it's so hard to touch, to see. So probably just only one way to do it, just to play with it.
Play with the idea.
Yeah, right.
Even to identify what the question is that your painting is about is hard sometimes, not only for you to identify, but especially for the audience. And you as an artist have to give a clue.
I would say that I try to pick up a very simple situation, very simple feeling of the human being, and I'll try just to find something else that stays behind of it. It always, I should tell a story about the Russian artist, because so many years they used to paint under the censorship, mm-hmm. and they felt much more comfortable to use a subtext. So even if I'm picking up a simple thing, simple situation, I tried to use the subtext. And you could see like two levels at the one painting. That's an idea of the paintings. And probably I could give a simple answer, and I could get for myself a simple answer from my painting. And at the same time, I try to reach something invisible.
Invisible.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
And at my painting.
So that there's a level that you think is more simple and one more sophisticated.
Yeah, probably that's mm-hmm. true. And even if for me, not just for audience, I don't want to say that someone would not be able to see something. Even if for me, even my painting is done, it's still questions for me. And I try to find the answers at the next paintings. Mm-hmm. So that's the reason probably some of my works are relative between each other. And
they're related one to the other.
Yeah, it's mm-hmm. sometimes it's the same idea, probably different situation, and I'm still asking and I'm still getting some answers. But mm-hmm. you'll see what happens.
Well,
we'll keep going here.
We'll take a look also at some of the paintings that you've been doing more recently at mm-hmm. the Griffis Art Center that you've been working on. And one group actually is a series.
Okay.
You say all of your work is a series in a way, but one of them you'll show us is done, actually evolved into three pieces that kind of go together.
Right.
And in this shot that we're going to share with the audience, Sasha will describe himself there at the studio. Some of his work. Let's take a look at that, and then we'll talk some more when we come back.
At first, I would like to say a couple words about a painting I did recently, being at the Griffis Art Center. The name of this painting is Wisdom of King Solomon. And this painting shows the meeting between King Solomon and the Queen. She brought a rich gifts for him, to listen to him, to get some advices from him. And she's listening carefully, and the wisdom of King Solomon shows all those animals that listen to him. It means that he could speak a language understandable for everybody. That's an idea of this painting. Right now, I would like to present another my paintings, like series of work I did after this. The name of another painting which I would like to represent you is The Blinds. This painting shows five people that stand probably at the center of the temple of the world. The stained glass at the back of those people shows like interior of the temple. All those people argue about what is the truth, what is the main idea of the world. And they have different meaning, different opinions, but they can't reach the main point because they are blind. It doesn't mean that they are blind physically, they are blind mentally. They just could not, they're thinking straight away and they could not reach the whole richness of the world. And they could not see how colorful it is. They could not see all sides of this, of the world. So even if they will try to say something, they will change, they will exchange an idea, they would not be able to reach the main point, what it's for and how it works and all this, what they are living for, all this, those ideas. So they're too little to reach the idea of this world, and they can't see it because they are blind. Now I would like to talk about some another paintings, which is a series of my works about man and woman relationship. The name of this painting is Ribbon Game. The ribbon that goes around woman and man figures means a different connection, different relation between man and woman. It means thoughts, actions, feelings, and different color of this ribbon means a different situation that happened between them. And the idea of this painting is that different color ribbon, different actions, different words could take people together, and at the same time it could take people apart. That's an idea of this painting. At the center of this series is a painting. The name of this is words. It could mean the beginning of relationship between man and woman, and at the same time it could mean the end of the relationship or the end of the connection between them, and all different patterns around them. It means a different word that could be start something and that could end something, and that's an idea of this painting. It's the beginning of something, and at the same time it could be the end. So that's a philosophic idea of this painting. Last one from this series, the name of this one is Bubble Makers. Now it's the last one, but probably I will work in this direction and I will do a couple more paintings. But the idea of this one, sometimes it happened between man and woman because of the character of a relationship between them. They could not do anything seriously. They could do only the bubbles. And even if they try and pretend that something goes between them, or they try to pretend that something breaks up between them, it's just bubbles. That's the name, that gives a name to this painting. Which is a Bubble Makers. Now, this one is the last painting from this series, but I think I will keep going in this direction, and you'll see some more paintings soon. This one not the best one, so don't put attention on this one. I don't
this
think
one,
it's
a... You know, when I look at all of this work, yeah. I think of so many sources, so many famous artists in art history. I think of Chagall, Marc Chagall and his yeah. floating figures. I think of Pierre Matisse with his multiple motifs filling yeah. up canvases, and Gustav Klimt with his constant right. curlicues yeah. filling up his figures.
Yeah.
Do you think of these?
Yeah, sure. It's you got this point. It's all artists you talk about are my favorite artists.
Oh, well, and, that's good that I see them
yeah,
in your
right.
work then.
Yeah,
where did you see this work? Did you study it?
Yeah, sure. I studied an art history, at history of the arts at the art college in Minsk, and also I used to teach history of the art at the children's oh. art school. And also
using all of these old masters
right,
as special.
Right. I tried to tell, it was not so long time, it was very short time, and it was impossible to tell about everybody I like, but I'll try to present my favorite artist for the kids, and I try to show them the best sides I have reached from them. And
but have you seen a lot of art that Marc Chagall
yeah,
has done and
sure.
Gustav Klimt and Pierre Matisse?
Yeah.
Where do you
I
look?
Was very happy because probably you know about the richest collections of the art at the Hermitage in St. Petersburg. And I remember the last year I studied at the art college, I went 4 times at the Hermitage to see different exhibits and also to get inspired from my favorite artist. And it's the last artist I was impressioned by was, well, like Vasily Kandinsky, it's a famous
oh,
Russian artist.
Sure.
Kes van Dongen, I saw one painting
sure.
at the Museum of the Fine Art down at the Boston, and I was very
yes.
happy. And
so you continue now that you're here to go to museums to see
yeah,
Kandinsky's.
Sure, sure. I think I'm absolutely need to
yes.
see the works of another artist, especially my favorite artist that given me forces to do my own
from inspiration.
Art. Yeah, right, right.
Well, the other thing is that I see in your work, and other artists, of course, have used too, the inspiration of the Bible, figures, studies,
yeah.
subjects, stories.
Yeah.
You use this as inspiration as well?
Yeah, sure. It's very rich material, the Bible. It's very smart and book. And a lot of famous artists, probably all old masters, used to read a Bible, and they try to take own look at this stuff. It's really rich material. And even if I don't have an idea where to go to paint, or even if I have so complicated question I could not find the answer, I could pick up the Bible tales, and I enjoy to work with this material, and so it really inspires me too.
But in your work, there are so many questions
yeah.
that you seem to talk about,
yeah,
even
right.
in that we just the clip
in
that we
tape.
Just saw.
Yeah, sure.
And obviously your art is talking about some of these questions
mm-hmm.
too. I'm wondering, when I listen to how you describe the work and
yeah.
what it means, how much do the politics of the world as you know it,
mm-hmm.
in your short 26 years,
yeah.
you know about all the instability in the Soviet
yeah,
Union.
Right.
You've watched a whole country
mm-hmm.
change.
Sure.
You've moved to a whole different place. You've.
Right.
How much does politics play in your influence?
I should say that usually culture has influence from the politics. I could tell you which way. Probably a couple years ago, before the new age of Russian politics, at the old times before a perestroika, all artists had to keep official line. I told about it already, they use a subtext at their works, but...
Subjects of their work?
Subtext.
Oh, a subtext of
subtext,
their work.
Yeah,
ah,
right.
Sorry.
And because it was a lot of censorship, but at the same time, it was not so much freedom, but at the same time, they had a chance to make a living being an artist.
Because they could.
Yeah, sure. They could paint some paintings at the official line.
Like, so they could make a living, but they had to paint those official paintings.
To make that living. I should say, more clear. Every little boss at his office had to have a portrait of communist leader or some members of Politburo, government. So it was a lot of
portrait painting.
Right, right.
And whether they wanted to or not, though, they had to do this to make the money.
They got a compromise. They did some portraits and they got some money from it, and they could buy on supplies and they could do something there really interesting.
Well, now that you're in America, you're much luckier than that. You can paint whatever subject you want, and in any color, in any way, in any size you want, whether a boss in an office needs it or not.
Right. But I should say that it's the same situation now in Russia. You could paint everything you want, but it's very hard to make a living. Uh-huh. But what is relative and similar, you should make a living here.
Well, and, it's difficult to be an artist everywhere in terms of making a living, but it's wonderful to be able to see you have the freedom to be able to paint what you want.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope that you get a chance to turn into Art Talk and visit the other artists that are artists in residence at the Griffis Art Center as well, so that you can see where they came from, both in their artistic attitude and their artwork.
It's a good experience for me.
Thank you, Sasha. Yes. Lots of good luck to you.
Thanks a lot.
Tune in again to Art Talk.